Hey guys, today I'm trying to explain apart from the Wi-Fi something else. I'm trying to myself to come up with some other things. So topic of discussion is network cable types and their specifications. So they are the things we are going to discuss today. First of all, we'll go to the through the introduction and what is coaxial cable, what is their specification. The second one is twisted pair cable specification again, and the final one is fiber optic cable. So first of all, we would like to know what is a network cable. So to connect two or more computers or networking devices in a particular network, network cables are used. Broadly, there are three types of network cables. First one is coaxial, second one is twisted pair, and the third one is fiber optic. So this is what called coaxial cable. This looks like this. Second one is twisted pair, and the third one is fiber optic. First of all, we'll look into the coaxial cable. This cable contains basically a conductor, the center one, then insulator, then the braiding, and the final one is sheath. So sheath is nothing but the outer layer of the coaxial cable. This is the outer layer where I am pointing now. So basically, this protects the cable from the physical damage. The braided is the second innermost part. So which protects signals from the external interface and noise. This shield is built from the same metal that is used to build the conductor. So the metal which is used for conductor and braiding are similar. So here, this and the pictorial presentation, you can see. The insulation part, it protects the core part. It also keeps the core separate from the braided shield, as both the shield as the both the core and braided shield use the same metal. Without this layer, they will touch each other and create a short circuit in the wire. Coming to the conductor part, the conductor is the innermost part which actually carries the electromagnetic signals. Based on the conductor of a coaxial cable, it is categorized into two parts, two types basically. Single core coaxial cable, and the second one is multi-core coaxial cable. This is how the single core coaxial cable looks like and the multi-core coaxial cable looks like. So basically, this single core coaxial cable uses a single central metal, which is usually a copper wire, that is the conductor. While the multi-core coaxial cable uses multiple thin strands of metal wires, the other things. So due to low cost and long durability, coaxial cables were used in computer networking for nearly two decades. Coming to the specification part of coaxial cable, there are some of the specifications: RJ6, RJ8, RJ58, RJ59, etc. So you can go through the detailed description, how does it looks like and what are the things. Where does it used? See here, the everything is mentioned. So this coaxial cables have been used for the last couple of decades, and during these years, based on several factors such as the thickness of the sheath, the metal of the conductor, and the material used in insulation, many specifications have been created to specify the characteristics of coaxial cables. So here are the different things. So what is RG, what is ohms, what is AWG, everything is mentioned over here. You can have a look to the details. What is twisted pair cable? This twisted pair cables were primarily developed for computer networking. This cable is also known as Ethernet cable. In most of the modern LAN computer networks, these cables are used. Basically, if you look at the colors, this cable consists of color-coded pairs of insulated copper wires. Every two wires are twisted around each other to form a pair. Usually there are four pairs. Each pair has one solid color and one stripped color. Solid color are blue, brown, green, and orange. They are the four categories. In stripped color, the solid color is mixed with the white color. This is how it looks like. Based on how pairs are stripped in the plastic sheath, there are two types of twisted pair cable. The first one is UTP cables, and the second one is STP cables. UTP means unshielded twisted pair cable. All pairs are wrapped in a single plastic wreath. So here you can see four cables are there, and these all things are wrapped on a single plastic sheath. Whereas in the case of STP, shielded twisted pair cable, each pair is wrapped with an additional metal shield. Here you can see clearly. Then all pair are wrapped in a single outer plastic sheath. So what are the similarities and differences between STP and UTP cables? Both STP and UTP can transmit data up to 10 Mbps, 100 Mbps, 1 Gbps, and 10 Gbps. Since the UTP cable maintains more materials, it is more expensive than UTP cable. By the way, both cables use the same RJ45, that is the resistor jack modular connectors. The STP provides more noise and EMI resistant than the UTP cable. Obviously, because each of the pairs are wrapped with the separate plastic, right? The maximum segment length of both the cables is 100 meters or 328 feet. Both cables can accommodate a maximum of 1024 nodes in each segment. This is the specification for twisted pair cable. There is an organization called TIA or EIA which specifies standards for the twisted pair cable. The TIA EIA 560 divides the twisted pair cable into several categories. So these are the some of the categories, name of the cable, like CAT1, CAT2, CAT3. I worked in CAT6 and CAT6A as well, but CAT7, this is the new technology and almost a little bit pretty costly, this one, so it's not so commonly used, but Yes, people are trying to use it now. What is the maximum support speed? What is the bandwidth support signal rate? What is the Ethernet standard? And some of the descriptions here it's given. So here if you look at it, category 5E, 6A, they're the most commonly used twisted pair cables. And finally, fiber optic cable. This cable consists of core, cladding, buffer and jacket. They're the four parts of this optic cable. The core is made from the thin strands of glass or plastic that can carry data over a long distance. The core is wrapped in the cladding. The cladding is wrapped in the buffer, and the buffer is wrapped in the jacket. I mean, one after one, it is cladded. Core carries the data signals in the form of a light. Cladding reflects the light back to the core. Whatever light will fall, it will reflect to the core part. Buffer protects the light from leaking, and the jacket protects the cable from physical damage. So this fiber optic cable is commonly completely immune to the EMI or RFI. This cable can transmit data over long distance at the highest speed. It can transmit data up to 40 kilometers at the speed of 100 Gbps. So if you look at this, it's damn good, and the optic cables are pretty costly as well. So here is the pictorial presentation. How does it looks like? This is a single mode fiber optic cable, and this is a multi-mode fiber optic cable. So fiber optics use the light to send data. It reflects the light from one endpoint to the another. Here you can look at this. How does it moves? The light falls, it reflects, and by the way, it can reach to the endpoint. So based on how many beams of light are transmitted at a given time, there are two types of fiber optic cables. One is single mode fiber optic cable, the other one is multi-mode fiber optic cable. This is multiple beams, this is single. Single mode fiber optic cables, these cables carry only a single beam of light, as the name specifies. This is more reliable and supports much higher bandwidth and longer distances than the MF cable. Also, this cable uses a laser as the light source and transmits 1300 to 1550 nanometer wavelengths of light. Coming to the multimode fiber optic cable, this also carries multiple beams of light, as we saw, instead of single beam of light. Because of multiple beams, this cable carries much more data than the SMF cable. Obviously, in the earlier case, there is a single source of light, but in this case, multiple sources are there. So this cable is used in shorter distances. Also, this cable uses LED as the light source and transmits 850 to 1300 nanometer wavelengths of light. In the earlier case, it was using the laser light, but in the MMF case, it used the LED light. Thank you so much. So, always questions and comments are welcome.